Good morning. Today we are going to represent female reproductive system. Here we will see the some topics which is very essential, that LS of female reproductive system in humans. So we will see this diagram. In this diagram we can understand that female have two important organs. One is called as primary organ and second is known as secondary organ. So in the primary organ, what we will study? We will study about ovary as well as uterus, labia majora, labia minora, as well as hymen, clitoris. In secondary organ, we will understand about mammary gland and related hormones. So we are going to start a description of LS of female reproductive system. In the case of female reproductive system, this is a diagram of an uterus which is representing. It have a fallopian tube. Fallopian tube is also known as oviduct. Fallopian tube is also known as oviduct. So here the ovary is shown, which is associated with the wall of outer wall of the uterus to the last region, which is known as fimbri. First of all, we'll understand that fallopian tube is divided into four parts. Especially first is known as fimbri ovary. That is called fimbri. This region, outer region, is called as fimbri, which is a finger-like projection. It is called as fimbri. It is segmented. This organ used to catch the ova from the ovary. Second is the infundibulum. Second important organ is infundibulum, which is above fimbri. It is called as infundibulum. Then we will see that the next organ, which is next part of the fallopian tube, it is called as ampulla. Ampulla is very important because mostly in 80% cases the fertilization takes place in ampulla region. The next is isthmus. Isthmus is the next important part of the fallopian tube. Now we will see that uterine fundus. Uterine fundus is also nearby to the both the arms. Actually the fallopian tube have, it is in one pair, left arm as well as right arm. Fallopian tube is also known as oviduct. So it is also called as oviduct. We will see that in ovary the oogenesis takes place and then the formation of ova takes place. Now we'll understand the walls of uterus. The uterus has especially three important walls or layers. The inner layer, which is black color representing, it is known as endometrium. Endometrium is the inner layer of the uterus where the zygote, which is a diploid structure, formation takes place and it will be implanted in endometrium region, as well as the placentation also takes place after that. Now the second layer, which is called as myometrium. Myometrium is the second layer. After endometrium, there is a myometrium layer, which is the second layer of the uterus. Now the outer layer, which we will see, this is called as perimetrium. The outer layer is known as perimetrium layer. It is providing the protection to the particular system, as well as they are very flexible in nature. Now we'll see here, this portion is known as cervix. Cervix is the middle part, as we can see here, it is called cervix. And the canal which is found in between, which is known as clavicle, cervical canal. It is a cervical canal. And here you will see, this is the canal type. Below canal, there is a vagina. There is a vagina. And nearby, at the lip of the uterus, when you will see the external part of the female genital organ, you will find that their hairs are present, which is called as pubic hair. As well as you will see that there are two walls. The thickest wall or thickest lip-like structure external to the female reproductive system, that is called as labia majora. That is labia majora. And below that, the second wall, it is known as labia minora. At the center top, there is a one peak-like shape. The cluster of neurons or nerves take place, that is known as clitoris, which is highly sensitive and it is correlated with the male penis head. That is the similarity between clitoris and male penis head. as we have already discussed in male reproductive system. Now one membrane is present for the protection, that is called as hymen, and the protection from bacterial infections and other infections. So that protective layer is known as hymen. It is a fine membrane which is present at the external part of the uterus. As well as we will see the, this is all description all about, as we have seen, the LS of female reproductive system. Now we will going to see how the oogenesis take place. So this is a diagrammatic section view of ovary. Diagrammatic section view of ovary will you understand. Here we will understand that what are the different steps, how the formation of ova take place. So we will see that this is a primary follicle. Primary follicle is enclosed with granulosa cells. These are the special type of cells which are nutritive in nature, and they provide nutrition to the primary follicle. And we can also see that there are two blood vessels. One is represented by red color and one is represented by blue color. Means red color blood vessel used to carry the oxygenated blood, as well as the blue color deoxygenated blood, and as well as nutrient in the form of glucose also, where the energy supply takes place inside the primary follicle. They are 60,000 to 80,000. When the puberty, before puberty, at the time of birth in female, approximately millions of, especially 60,000 to 80,000 approximately ovas are found, and they are in the form of arrested cells, which is called as primary follicle, and later on that get mature into secondary, this tertiary follicle, secondary follicle. As we can see, primary follicle will mature in secondary follicle, and then the secondary follicle will mature in tertiary follicle. This is the diagram of tertiary follicle, which is showing the antrum. Antrum is that region where the fluid is filled in the cavity. This fluid is filled in the cavity is known as antrum. Important function to provide the nutrient material for the growth and development of oocyte or follicle, that is a tertiary follicle. As you can see here, this is the next stage is from tertiary follicle, the formation of gaffrine follicle takes place. The gaffrine follicle, which is having an important function, that from the help of gaffrine follicle, there is an outer layer which is called as zona pudica in the gaffrine follicle, and from that only, when it gets mature, it is converted into ovum. Then here the ovum is released, as you can see, ovary, the ovum is released. This ovum is also known as secondary oocyte. This ovum is also known as secondary oocyte. So once again we will understand how the formation of ova take place or ovum take place. Here the mature female gamete, which is under the process of oogenesis, it is start from embryonic developmental stage. As we can make a recap here, we can see that the primary follicle will be get mature into secondary follicle, then the formation of tertiary follicle take place, which have the antrum, which is a fluid like structure, it is found in a cavity. Then from tertiary follicle, the formation of gaffrine follicle take place, and from the gaffrine follicle, the formation of secondary oocyte or ovum take place. The formation of oocyte or secondary oocyte or ovum from the gaffrine follicle is known as ovulation. So this is all about the diagrammatic section view of ovary. Now we'll understand the secondary organs as essential organs in female reproductive system, that is mammary gland. So we'll talk about the mammary gland. This is a diagram showing LS of mammary gland. LS means longitudinal section of mammary gland. We can see here, this is the internal part which is directly associated to the epigastrium region. Epigastrium region of the female body. And here you can see that these are the dotted structure, which is called as ribs. It is shown here because we are talking about the LS section. And after that, in between the ribs, there is a intercostal muscles, or we can say that muscular muscles between the ribs. They are muscles between the ribs, which is highly contractile in nature. Now the inner, as we can see here, this layer is known as pectoralis, major muscles. Pectoralis, major muscles are formed by which the mammary gland is attached. Now we see that inside there, these are blue color fats which are accumulated, and they are formed maximum in number, which having a function that they provide the nutrient material as well as for the formation of milk. Here we can see this is known as your mammary lobe. This is the mammary lobe. Here the mammary alveolus is seen, which is shown with the help of dotted structure, mammary alveolus. And this duct is known as mammary duct. Here we can see the external, these are the internal ampulla. This region is known as ampulla, which is a thin tube like structure which provide the passage for the lactation. Now we will see the lactiferous duct. It is directly associated with the ampulla, and this outer portion which we can see here, this is the junctions where the cavity or the pores are seen directly, that is called as nipple. And now we will see that this outer layer of the mammary gland, which is called as areola. So what is the function of nipple? This is the function that the baby directly take a milk from mother mammary gland. So this is for providing the nutrition to the baby, basically the infants. Now after this we will find one more important thing, that how the ischemic representation of oogenesis take place. We will see in female reproductive organ how the ischemic representation of oogenesis take place. Suppose this is an oogonia, which will go under the mitosis, differentiation, and then the formation of primary oocyte take place. From oogonia, the formation of primary oocyte take place by the help of mitosis differentiation. At the case of oogonia, the chromosome number is 46 chromosome. Then the mitosis, the formation of two cells take place, which is called as primary oocytes. They are known as primary oocytes. Then after primary oocyte, the formation of secondary oocyte take place. The secondary oocyte formation take place by the help of first meiotic cell division, which is completed prior to the ovulation. So first meiotic cell division, which is completed prior to the ovulation, by which the oogonia, which used to make a primary oocyte, and from primary oocyte the formation of secondary oocyte take place. And from the secondary oocyte we can see the ovum formation take place. The ovum formation take place, or we can say that secondary oocyte formation take place. The ovum which is formed by secondary oocyte, has shown there, it used to release ovum. Now we see the first mitotic cell division in which 23 chromosome formation take place. Means chromosome number will become half, and one polar body will be degenerated. The first polar body will be degenerated in the case of secondary oocyte also. Here the second polar body will be degenerated and one ovum formation will take place. So this is the stepwise process of flowchart ischemic representation formation of oogenesis, means ovum. Now one more important thing we will have to talk about, that what are the female related hormones. So there are three very essential hormones which is found in female reproductive system and their release. First hormone is known as progesterone. First hormone is progesterone, which is a major hormone in female reproductive organ. They used to maintain the internal wall of uterus, which is called as endometrium. Same way we talk about the second important hormone, which is known as estrogen. Estrogen is that important hormone. After the maturation cycle, the wall of the uterus formation takes place, and one more important function of the estrogen is that the secondary sexual characters, like basically the characters like progesterone and estrogen both combinedly, they control the secondary sexual character in female. Like they do not have moustaches, they have high pitch voice, and third is their mammary gland is developed. And the third hormone which we will understand, that is called as oxytocin. Oxytocin is the third important hormone which we have to understand its function. It has two important functions. First function is that in the lactation, it used to make a formation of milk. and it helps in the lactation. The first function of oxytocin is that is helps in lactation. And second important function, at the time of childbirth means partition, the uterus opening, it used to extend the opening by which the passage will be extended with the help of a hormone called oxytocin, by which the childbirth easily can take place. In some cases we have seen also that doctors used to give the oxytocin injections for the proper delivery. Now we will see one more important function that we have seen, that in many animals we used to give the oxytocin injection because they used to give more lactation, more milk for me they can give or they can release. So it have the function that they used to do the vasodilation. So oxytocin function is that they used to help in vasodilation. So these are the hormones which are very essential in female reproductive organ. So we have understand the structure of your female reproductive organ. We have understand second thing which is called as the diagrammatic section view of ovary. This is the ovary, how they used to work, primary follicle, then secondary, then tertiary follicle. Then from tertiary follicle, the formation of gaffrine follicle, and then from gaffrine follicle, ovum formation takes place, and this is called as ovulation. So this we have understand, and we have also understand the ischemic representation of oocytes. That here we understand that oogonia, from oogonia formation of primary oocyte, then secondary oocyte, and then ovum formation takes place, where the chromosome number is 46 in the case of oogonia. Then with the help of meiotic cell division, it is reduction division also it is known as, and then you can see that chromosome number become half, that is 23, and same, then mitotic cell division, second polar body will be degenerated, first and second polar body will be degenerated at different level, like primary oocyte and secondary oocyte level, and then the formation of ovum take place. We have also seen the diagram. This is the LS of mammary gland, as I have already explained how the lactation takes place and which region it is associated. Mammary gland is found in one pair and it is associated at the epigastrium region with the help of pectoralis major muscles. Thank you.